God's elect, the one that he's chosen. If you've been chosen by God, promotion. This inheritance is laid out for us in heaven. And it says, verse 5, this is where we will be, who are kept by the power of God through faith.
Yeah.
My sisters and my brothers, we are kept by the power of God. And this power will keep you. It will keep us. No matter what's going on in our lives, it will keep us. So John said, to them that he gave the power to become the son, to many that receive him, they become the power, the son of God to receive that power. So therefore, we are kept by the power. This power will keep you. Isaiah said it perfectly. I will keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on me. This power will keep us. Now, we're not talking about black power and white power. We're talking about the power of God. Dunamis. This Holy Ghost power will keep us. No matter what we're going through, what's going on in our life, this power will keep us. So we are kept by the power of God through faith. We got to believe that God's going to do what he says he's going to do. We got to have faith to believe it even when we don't see it at times. But if we got faith to believe God going to come through and do what he says he's going to do, when he's going to do it, we have to trust that God knows us best and he knows what he's doing. Because his power will keep you.
Amen.
It will keep you. He is our bridge over troubled water. There are troubles in all of our lives. But this power will keep you through your trouble, through hardship, when times are hard, when death of a loved one, when there's sickness in our bodies, when we sometimes we don't know if we're going back or forth. Sometimes we don't know when our money be like little change, little money, but this power will keep you. He will supply all of our needs. Because he promised, he said, I'll supply all of your needs according to your riches, to my riches in Christ Jesus. So this is what he said. He don't care. And that must be faith. Faith needs an object. We got to have faith. Now we have faith, we trust in a lot of things. When we sit on the bench and when we come here, we trust that that bench is going to hold us. But the thing about it, do we have the same kind of faith in our God? Knowing that he's going to do what no other power can do. Knowing that if he said it, he's going to bring it to pass. No matter what it is, y'all, we have to continue to trust in the Lord with all our hearts and lean not to our own understanding. In all our ways, just acknowledge him.
Oh, yeah.
These Christians were going through spiritual persecution. And Peter, this apostle Peter, just wrote to tell them, you are kept.
Yeah.
And the word kept in the Greek means garrison. We are surrounded by the power of God. No matter what we do, God's power rests upon us. God will keep us if we trust in him with all our heart, if we lean out to our own understanding. He will do that for us. Now, we can't fabricate this power. This power lives on the inside of us. None other than the Holy Spirit. He's our elder brother. He lives in us. He leads us. He guides us and he comforts us. This power here will keep you. Will keep us. When everything else is, all around us is falling apart, he will keep us. Why? No matter what's going on in our lives, he knows our name. And he told us in Isaiah, he said, I'll be with you. He said, when you go through the water, the water will take you. Go through the fire, it's going to burn you. Why? Because I am with you. This is what he's saying to us this morning. This power will keep us. It will keep us. It will keep our children. This power only comes from having a genuine relationship with God. We got to know what we have. Because we have this power. He said we are kept by the power of God through faith. This power will keep us. It will keep us. It will keep us. And you know what? It will keep us from making decisions and saying things out of our mouth that we shouldn't say, because the Holy Spirit lives on the inside of us. And he'll let us know, you shouldn't say it like that. You shouldn't do it like that. That's the kind of power that we have being God's people. This power will keep us. He said, ready to But guess what? When we in prayer, we be praying for this power. Say, I'll take care of you and your descendants. I'll keep them. This power will keep us.
And this is what Peter was saying this morning. This power. A living hope. We have a living hope with this power.
This, the Holy Spirit will keep us. He will mold us. He will shape us. He will comfort us. He will keep us. This is what he will do. He'll be our bridge over trouble. Lord, this power. Encourage you to know that God will keep us no matter what's going on. was given unto me in heaven and earth. Leading it to be on that same power that raised Jesus from the dead, because we are kept by the power of God through faith. That's my word to you this morning.
I see you.